Good morning, cultists. Welcome back to another Unbalanced Breakfast with Cthulhu's. So in our last episode, we had another holy crusade waged against us. And the Christians all wanted to go Deus Vault and shit, but then we taught them a lesson. We kicked their asses, sent them all packing. And now my two twins have come of age and stuff, I guess. And then I also invoked the power of Satan to get who was it? It's the guy with a shitty beard, the Dorito here, a disease, and currently he is suffering from a horrible bout of explosive shits, which is great, but not kind of the extent that I was hoping for. And also, there's been a recent development. It's here. The Black Death has finally come, and it will purge the world of, well, anyone who's not me and it done, basically. So I'm kind of hoping it'll kill everyone off, and I get to do like a clean slate kind of thing, but we'll see. I think our main... Oh, thank you. Our main areas here actually do have hospitals. Oh, the sky doesn't? Oh wait, the sky is not part of mine, never mind. Yeah, I could improve the sick house and stuff. I don't know if that's really gonna be all that necessary. Temple Vassal Opinion, disease resistance and all that stuff. There's some stuff here that does give me... Actually, it seems like the vast majority of these do give me a fair bit of, some benefits here that might actually be useful. Huh. Interesting. Well, if I have more money, I'll try to improve the hospitals, but in the meantime, we are moving our troops down here to wage war against Mali. Our defensive packs, or rather the defensive packs against us, are still well entrenched in the world. But I think we should be able to take over Mali quickly enough that it won't be a problem. That being said though, they do have over 500 prestige, which means that once we go to war against them, they will most likely summon their tribal troops, so this might not be worth it. It's not that big enough of a difference in troop size that I think it'll be a smart idea here. Ibn Battuta is a renowned traveler, so when he returned home to Tangier, I invited him to tell me tales of his travels, and I was not disappointed. Ambushes, bandits, famous mosques, beautiful cities, and all sorts of adventures had Ibn Battuta seen and experienced. Great. Ooh, how does that affect me? It probably doesn't. Could you make threat decay a little faster, please? Because, gotta say, you're a little slow there, buddy. Kinda hoping you'd, make it go down a lot faster than what it is now. Okay, when it says threat decay speed, 16%. Does that mean it's actually 16% of 2.42 or whatever it was before 2.42? Because that is abysmally low still. So I don't know if that's really all that worth it. And this is why I wanted to continue the series as with the Monks and Mystics update, but no. Okay, who exactly died? Did you die? No, you didn't die. My Chancellor died. Great. Okay, Wilfredo, you are now my guy, and you're also... Okay, your threat decay speed is a little lower. Not great. I think it's this guy that died, or the guy who ruled over Africa, or North Africa, rather. Alright. Looks like we need to reinstate someone. Possibly. What's happening over here? We're at war with each other? Good grief, you sons of bitches. Should we make Joel McHale our, the ruler of North Africa? Might not be the worst idea in the world. I mean, his stats are probably better out of the, lot here. Which isn't really saying much, because they all kind of suck shit. They're only rulers, basically, because their fathers are... their parents were rulers and shit. Ah, jeez. Fine, Joel McHale, you are ambitious, but you can be the viceroy or of whatever. And I'm actually going to include all lower titles. Because even though this doesn't actually give you all the lower titles, I think it's the thought that counts and all that stuff. Fantastic. Alright, buddy. Giving you all the lower titles better not come back to bite me in the ass, Joel McHale. Alright, man? Good. We could shut the gates, but I'm not going to. And apparently I have beaten slow fever, fantastic. Well, that took a while for that disease to go away, which is why I tried to avoid the diseases in the first place. Because sometimes you get severe illness and that doesn't go away for a while, and then that's a huge hit to your stats. So if you're ever wondering like, oh, why the fuck does he try to avoid diseases? He's immortal and he's brawny, it doesn't really matter. Yeah, it doesn't really matter, but it still affects my stats rather negatively. And I'd rather avoid that if I can, so yeah. We could upgrade the Kazbaz, but I think it might not be the worst idea in the world to invest in some sick houses and whatnot. So let's go with that. Let's invest in these. It's gonna be a lot of money, but you know what? That's okay. Because we have money coming out of the wazoo. Liuva, just do your own fucking shit, man. I don't really give a rat's ass about you. We are willing to share. Actually, try to be gregarious if you can. And he, in fact, became charitable. Fantastic. Why do I even bother making a choice? Why do I bother? Piggy, you can be our commander. And Blake, you can also be our commander. Because I want you guys to get the hell away from here. Look, it's coming, okay? There's no way to stop this shit. I've tried, believe me. So I think once the disease really starts to come in full force, we're gonna get these guys on boats and try to get them as far away as we can. What is this? Why is... Oh, I know why that is. Okay, so... You guys probably know that I have the mod, like, Revolutionary Watercolors or whatever. And part of the changes that were made in the latest patch, the 2.7, is that they have moved certain areas to be certain bodies of water, like rivers and whatnot, to be in, like, more historic, more, and actually, not historically, because it's not like they actually changed, to be in more accurate locations, geographically accurate locations. And I think this little island thing used to be over here, but then they realized that it's not actually there in real life, so then they just moved it over here. And then now the mod's like, well, this part of the water is also dark, but it's not. Fun story, right? I know. I'm just full of cool stories, bro. Shut up. Can we upgrade this? No, we still need a little bit more money, which isn't bad. Spymaster is not doing anything because he is afraid of slow fever. Great. Fine, you just hide out in your little thing. Actually, you're in Constantinople. Oh, probably smart idea, actually. Guys, it's coming. It's really coming in full force here. So, it's been nice knowing everyone, I think. Probably-ish. But you know what? I mean, if my sons die, it's still not the worst thing in the world. Because I can just, you know, make new ones, right? Just as, our son, Too Many Babies, demonstrates with his name. Gonna be 5,000 troops there? That's fine, I guess. Great, and now people are still suspicious of me. Fantastic. I don't know what the point of that is then. Are they suspicious of me or not? Like, you tell me that they're not suspicious of me, but they're still suspicious of me, so... I don't know what you're talking about. Okay, slow fever has seems to have, slowed to a crawl, or at least stopped its progression. But the Black Death is definitely coming over. Holy shit. How you guys doing over here? Anyone here suffering from the Black Death? No? Ain't nobody got the blizzy? Hey, nobody got the Blizzy. That's kind of a shame. I was kind of hoping to see more people with the Blizzy. Persia ravaged by the plague. Great. Yeah, I just looked at it, man. You don't need to tell me twice. Whoa. What happened here? Alright, great. Fantastic. I guess I'll just lower these guys now. And actually, let's have a little fun with this guy. You there, sir. Are you maybe a virgin that I could sacrifice to Satan? Or should I induct him? Nah. Let's sacrifice him. And he was not, in fact, a virgin. That's kind of a shame. Wow, people are just really quick to jump on the suspicion train against me. Too many babies. Just learn on your own. I clearly didn't give enough shit about you to actually give you a proper name. So, yeah. Though my last act of worship has been some time ago, I can still sense the inhuman or inhuman touch upon my soul whenever I think about what I did. I become a changed man. I was possessed before I got in touch with Satan, okay? God. Satan can learn from me, that son of a bitch. That's right. You heard me right. Can I upgrade to... Oh no, I need to desecrate this thing. Let's do it. Fantastic. Get out of here, stupid Vikings. It is time. I would rather avoid killing imams if I can, or barons or whatever. And no, I don't think we need to loot their shit. Ooh. Liuva, you became a brilliant strategist with a not-so-brilliant mustache. Fine. Dark deeds done in secret. Fantastic. The plague approaches. Heathen filth are bringing the plague here. It's coming. It's not fully here yet. I do still need to watch out for it, though. Because it spreads pretty quickly. Middle East ravaged by plague. You son of a bitch. Really? Really? You want me to taint the touch? Do you want me to touch your taint, son? Bastard. Good grief. Songs of anguish. My nights are plagued by terrible nightmares featuring the vile Brunechildis de Barnaco, my rival sister in darkness. Is she really a rival? I feel like she's not, but okay. She howls and roars at me to the tune of infernal bagpipes while Asmodeus looks on, bellowing with laughter. I am sure that Shaitan is sending me these dreams for a reason. I must prove myself worthy or be discarded as a weakling. Such is the way of Lucifer's own. Let's invite Brunechildis over for some fun. She'll think this is an offer of reconciliation, but I'll have her screams for real. Fantastic. Okay, great. As Brunechildis arrived for our meeting, my servants threw a sack over her and beat the filthy glutton into submission. She is now snugly stowed in a brazen bull that I had built especially for this occasion. Surrounding the bull are some crucified scum from my dungeon, drenched in oil. It took some work to find three genuinely insane musicians, but as they start up their demented tune and the fires are lit underneath the bull, I lean back and realize it was all worth it. As soon as the first bellows start issuing forth from the bull, I order the human candles lit. I close my eyes and hum along with the infernal choir, my nightmares conquered once and for all. These are the pleasures that await us all in hell. And I gain Impaler, fantastic. Yeah, like how many times can I be possessed? Holy shit. And demonic possession of Argante de Pen. Okay, great, we can do that. Argante de Pen? Your husband died of smallpox. Not that it really... Whoa. Excuse me. Wrong person, thank you. There we go, let's demonically possess this girl and hope that she doesn't die while I'm possessing her. Great. So that I'm not possessing a corpse again. I love seeing this. I mean, I'm not some kind of like, you know, sadist that's like, oh, I love seeing like people catch black plague and die. No, it's more like it's nice red color. It's kind of like pierces my eyeballs and actually kind of gives me a bit of a headache. But you know what? It's still nice to look at this whole like unified thing, which is kind of what I hope to accomplish with the March of the Jewish Horde campaign. You know, turning the whole world yellow. That was pretty cool. Anyways. Not everything has gone according to plan, although something quite clearly seems to have taken up residence within Argante. Whatever it is does not seem to be inclined to make Argante more loyal towards you. Was she possessed before? Oh shit, no. I become arbitrary. Please. Please, no. No arbitrary. Let's go rulership. Also, when was the last time I actually went hunting? Good grief. I don't think I have had any kind of like, anything fire off from my hunting, thing in quite a while. Can you stop your plotting, please? What is this? Inherited the Kingdom of Galicia. Too many pop-ups. Okay, let's deal with these. Unmarried heir, whatever, I don't really give a shit. Does your claims... Whoa. What is your deal? How come only the, Western Europeans got, like, new portraits and shit? Spymaster? You're a dumbass. You're just hiding away, because you're... whatever. Fine. Request rank up? Or observe Ramadan? Definitely request rank up. And we can send Ermanadildo into hiding? Definitely not. We can imprison this guy? No, we can't. We need a new commander. Fantastic. That's one pop-up gone out of like the millions that I have. Good grief. Successor nomination? What are you talking about? Oh, I see. Because of this. Should you be the new guy? New king? Or should it be you? Let's make it you. Congratulations, buddy. Can you get it? Can you do something about your eye, man? Like, I get that you have only one eye, but can you not be wearing, like, a bloody bandage? You're a fucking king, or at least a duke. You're king now, but you were duke before. Can't you afford, like, a better eye patch or something that doesn't look so ridiculous? Good grief. Fantastic. Ah, yes, I become a priest! What does this mean? I get to have a dark divorce. So, annul my marriage in the name of Iblis. In exchange for dark power, so I guess that'll kill my spouse. Dark healing on my character's portrait in order to perform a dark ritual to heal myself. Oh, in exchange for dark power, so I have to give dark power. I don't get dark power for sacrificing my wife. What? Invite disciple of Iblis. Enable a decision to invite a member of Lucifer's own to join you at your court.
Aha!
Can I then do it to anybody? You, sir, would you like to join my court as a dude? No? Fine. Can I heal myself with the dark power of Satan? I need 300 dark power. Or I need to be wounded, maimed, or have a disease or a serious medical condition. Okay, great. So, say I get gout or something again. I can probably use that to cure myself, right? Hopefully. Let's upgrade our sick houses and shit before the Black Death comes. Because it's here. We need to get the hell out of here. Right, so we'll get one of these. Do I want the shock troops? Can I get the defense guys? Yeah, and you guys will... actually, let's get a couple of these. Yeah, because I need... Actually, what am I doing? Oh, right. So I need to get my sons, Piggy and Blake. You are the best of my sons. The Dorito actually has decent stats, but he's a piece of shit. So we're just gonna ignore him. You guys are gonna... If I can speak properly, please. Tongue, thank you very much. You guys are gonna get on a boat and get the hell out of Dodge. If we can get a boat over here, please. Do I have a boat here? I don't have a shipyard here, do I? Son of a bitch. That's unfortunate. Alright, well, actually, I can... still raise these. And I guess they'd be a little unhappy about it, but... you guys can suck it for all I care. Alright. Great. Now get the hell out of here, sons. Where do I want you to go? Probably to Iceland, I'm thinking? Although, who knows? The Black Death might still follow you there, so... have fun with that. Oh no, Friedland! What is with your face, man? Holy shit! Doctor! Cure his pneumonia. India ravaged by the plague. Here it comes! Although I'm kinda sad it didn't go farther north. Sooner. Died of the dreaded plague. Oh shit! Domain too big. Oh jeez. Good grief. Who died? Oh. Load filter. Oh shit. If I give you guys these counties, will you survive, please? Cause I really like you there, Lupo. Please survive. Don't die, okay, buddy? And then we will give... Pelagio? Even though you're ambitious, you're homosexual, and so that should cancel out the negative from ambitious towards me, I'm thinking. But we're gonna make him the Duke, okay, buddy? The Duchy of Toledo. And you get to take all the lower titles or whatever. Yeah, I did some reading on the Reddit, Crusader Kings 2 Reddit, and or I guess it's just the Crusader Kings Reddit. And it turns out that whenever you can, just do the include lower titles, especially if it doesn't actually include lower titles. Because if you have like, say I wanted to give this county away. This is for those of you who aren't aware of the whole include lower titles thing. Say I wanted to give Burgos away for whatever reason, like I, for some reason, maybe I'm drunk or something, and I'm playing, and I'm like, oh, I'm gonna give away Burgos, because it's funny. And then I decide to find a guy, he's like, here dude, take Burgos, and then if I do include lower titles, not only does it give Burgos to him, but it actually gives these two baronies to him as well. Now, if you don't actually own these, it doesn't actually go to him, but... I think for some reason he just still likes the sentiment. He's like, oh, you I guess it's the thought that counts. You want to give me these lands, but you can't. That doesn't really matter, because too many babies. What the fuck happened to you? What? You look like some kind of fucking dirty bum. Holy shit. My god, too many babies. Did you look upon Rilia? Or something? Holy crap, look at his face! He looks like some kind of dirty bum that we scavenged out from like the depths of the ocean or something. Holy crap! And now he's wearing a hood. Well, you know what? That at least covers up a part of your dirty face. Not enough, not gonna lie, but a part of it at least. And that's it. The hospitals did absolutely nothing to stop the disease, from the Black Plague, from spreading into my lands. Great. Liuva, you might die. You're probably gonna die. That's okay, buddy. You can die for all I care. Fantastic. Here comes the Great Purge. Oh no, Armanadildo. Ah, beset by high fever and cannot stop vomiting. Ah, he's as the dreaded plague. Oh, Armanadildo. I'm gonna keep my steward, okay, wifey poo. My lord, there is a noble warrior at the gate. He says he is a veteran of many battles and desires to become a champion of your house. He praises your wisdom and honor and pledges to always defend you and your butthole and your household if you will accept him in your retinue and maybe get him to bend and spread every now and then. Fantastic. Need to get a new couple of commander. Ooh, Asur. I'm guessing you're one of the, you're the new guy that just came in. And we are in fact going to get Ordono, the dwarf, to be a commander. Absolutely fantastic. It's gonna be like Game of Thrones. No spoilers, please. I haven't seen the latest season, which is in fact driving my girlfriend quite insane because I haven't seen the latest season. Ah, like, oh, the hell, man. Gotta watch it. Okay. Anyways, Gonzalo, you can have the Toledo. And you are going to be the new Duke of Toledo as well. And we're going to include all lord titles, even though it actually means nothing. Congratulations, you're probably going to die. Because everyone is dying. Oh no, my daughter, she's also got the Black Plague. Oh no, my wife also has the Blizzy. Yep. Here comes the Black Great Purge. Oh, there goes my wife. Fantastic. Let's get them to straighten up in the meantime, because I don't really want them to, you know, get me too many, incur too much decadence for me. But, they shouldn't really be surviving for too long now. Great. Everyone is dying, and it's fantastic. Liuva, sure, why don't you be my, commander? And Liuva, here. I really need you guys to oversee these armies. Like, seriously, it's of the utmost importance, guys. Please. Please. Look after this army here. Oh, shit. Oh, right. This seriously destroys the supply limit of the province. Shit. Yeah, I need to spread these guys out. Oh, no, Liuva. Sickness and death await us all. Stop pestering me. Oh, he's dead. Fantastic. They're all dropping like flies and it's amazing. Do we want the dwarf as our spy master? Yeah, sure. Although he's our commander too, so I might need to rejig that a little bit. But that's okay. My regent? What? Oh, it's because I inherited West Friesland? Really? Good grief. Get the hell out of here, West Friesland. Man. What a sack of nuts. Alright, let's give West Friesland to Asur. Come on, man, really? You had to catch the plague too? Fine. Oliva, you can take West Friesland. And we should, you know what? Once the Great Purge has come and gone, we'll get married again. But in the meantime, who else needs to die? Armanadildo needs to die. Piggy! There we go. Oh, I'm sick. I probably have the Black Plague as well. That's fine. How you guys doing over here? Oh, scurvy. Shit! Okay, I didn't think they would get scurvy so quickly. But maybe it's just one of my sons. I don't know. Why don't you guys just hang out there for a little bit? Until your scurvy goes away. Really? You're over the supply limit, how? Oh, it's because they're pagan lands, son of a bitch. Did you guys build a fort or something? No? Yeah, I got the malaise, cool. The feuding between Duke Ordono of Badajoz and Duke Sonny Alfredo the Evil has reached your court. Okay. And can no longer be ignored, as your vassals both have brought their grievances against each other to support. In the hope that you garnering your support. Both are quarreling like children. And we gained Diligent! This is exactly what I wanted! Fantastic! And we got the cramps. That's fine. And we got the Black Plague. Also fine. It ain't gonna kill me. I really hope it doesn't kill me. I have encountered Abjur Hakur many times while carrying out my duties for Lucifer's Own, and it is always a pleasant occasion. We can talk for hours if the time allows, because he never bores me. While our discussions are often lengthy, we always seem to agree on the matters which are most important.
Oh, hello, sailor. Oh. Maybe. Hakur, maybe you like to go for a little jog and into the woods. Should we though?
Let's just be friends. I don't think I need a lover in him. Nah, it's fine. Alright, Blake, are you done with your scurvy? Great. Cause you're gonna get back on a boat very soon, because all this shit is just coming up. in the middle of all this, you still want me to go around killing people. Is this not enough for Satan? Oh, whoa. Holy shit. It's cleared up pretty quickly. Damn. I guess there's not enough people for the disease to spread, right? Yeah, that's probably it. And what do you want me to do? You want me to desecrate another temple? Fantastic, sure. I'll do that. Let's go and desecrate another temple. Fantastic. And, I'm hoping they're gonna be okay to stay here, but we'll see. As I and a group of blah blah blah, I see Baron Nuno. Do I really want to kill him? Let's do it. Because I gain dark power. It'll be fantastic. And more dark power, please. Small treasure. Huh. Let's... I kind of want something in my treasure. Oh. Whoa. When did I get all this stuff? Holy shit. This is fantastic. I'm wearing golden bracelets. Lovely. Throwing axe? Oh shit, yeah. Or a bejeweled dagger. Holy crap. I had no idea I had these things. This is incredible. Oh shit. Oh, I inherited it from Athanadildo of West Friesland. Oh, that's cool. That is fantastic. Do I want the throwing axe? Or do I want the bejeweled dagger? I like martial score, so I'm gonna go with the throwing axe for now. Oh, can I have both? Oh, ceremonial weapon. Oh, that's fantastic. Let's steal these things. Maybe if I go around looting temples and shit, I can actually add stuff to my treasury. Oh, this is fantastic. Holy crap. Yes. More dark power. Please. Should I start healing myself to get rid of my black plague? I don't think it's really all that necessary. Anyways, that's gonna have to be it for this episode. Hope you guys are liking the new changes from Monks and Mystics. I apologize for the UI still being a little different. I was looking into it, and the author of the mod for the bigger interface UI mod is actually working on an update, so hopefully in the next in the next four or so episodes, it'll probably stay this way, because I don't know when he or she is going to be able to complete the update. But after this batch of recordings, hopefully we should, in the next week or so, see an update to the, or see me using the expanded UI stuff, and hopefully some of the other mods that I don't know if I had to turn off or not. I forgot. But anyways, that's a lot of gravestones. That's a lot of dead bodies. I'm okay with it. Fantastic. I love being immortal. Holy shit. But yeah, let's leave it off here for now and come back again tomorrow for some more Crusader Kings 2, where hopefully we will take over Mali or something. I don't know, because my threat's still fairly high. Yeah, we'll see. Anyways, thanks for watching and have a good breakfast.